Yes.
You keep... Ooh, that's cool over there.
Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Boston from Indie Film School. Thanks so much for liking and subscribing to our channel. It always helps. We really appreciate it. In today's video, we're going to show you how you can take any real-world environment and turn it into a 3D environment like this using this. First off, we want to thank our sponsor, Displayland, for sponsoring this video. Of course, if you haven't already, go click the link in the description and download their free app that we will use to scan our 3D worlds. It's amazing, it's free, and it's the perfect first step. If you've never done 3D scanning or photogrammetry before, it's a wonderful app that you can use to get that introduction. So let's break down this process in 5 very, very simple steps. And then we're gonna explain a little bit about how this technology can be expanded upon and be used in film and television and even video games.
It's a sunny, rainy day.
It's raining.
No, it's sprinkling.
So to set up what we're doing today, we're using a process called 3D scanning or photogrammetry. But just to keep that super simple, basically, up until recently, what photogrammetry meant was you would take a bunch of photos with a nice camera, run that through a computer program, and boom, it'll create a 3D object based upon your photo images. For example, this is a 3D scan of the demolition derby car we used in our concept trailer for Alien Country, our featured film. Now, this process has been made even easier, and you can do it with the app Displayland. So that leads to step number 1, which is click the link below and download the app, but you will actually create a user profile. Displayland is actually set up as an app where you kind of have a social network and can share your different scans. You can follow me, you can follow our film, you can see the stuff that we're creating, that others are creating, and get a little inspired. Step number 2, you have to pick something that you want to photo scan. So, Rennie and I recently did a photo shoot at a gas station, and I decided that would be a perfect opportunity to test this app. So a few years back, when we were making our concept trailer for Alien Country, the feature film we're doing, we went to this gas station and filmed a scene. And then we decided we needed to make some poster art, and even though I'm not actually going to be in the poster art, I was a stand-in, and we went back to the gas station and did a photo shoot. But we had a little bit of extra time during the shoot because the sun hadn't quite set, so we went around and I tested the app and scanned around the gas station. We then did our photo shoot, I uploaded my scan to the cloud, and by the time we were done, boom, I had a 3D mock-up of this gas station. Now there were a lot of reflective surfaces and such, windows, and so it wasn't a perfect first attempt. So a good rule of thumb here is to, when you're picking your area, avoid reflective surfaces, find non-reflective surfaces with a lot of detail to them. Also avoid poles and thin objects like wires, because that might not pick up as well with your camera. So with that in mind, for this video, Rennie and I decided to go the extra mile, or rather the extra 100 plus miles, and head to Goblin Valley State Park in Utah with our puppy Rebel to use this app to capture one of the most bizarre alien landscapes on the planet. Roll epic footage.
So we're on our way to Goblin Valley.
Yes.
Which, if anybody hasn't been there, you must go.
It's absolutely bizarre, cool. It's a landscape that's been featured in feature films like Galaxy Quest, so pretty interesting place. It just looks like another planet.
It literally looks like little monsters are crawling all over this valley of red rock. Yeah. Hence the name Goblin Valley. Oh yeah, baby.
Rebel, you ready?
He's ready.
I'm ready.
You just don't even know what you're ready for.
So I'm prepped with puppy. I'm prepped with the puppy treats. I'm prepped with my camera, and Boston's just prepping some GoPros.
Right, booting up the app. We picked Goblin Valley because it's iconic. And these unique land shapes are gonna be really easy to capture on a small scale or on a big scale. So depending on what we want to do for our final product, we can have something very little or something very big. And it'll still be very interesting regardless.
Yes, indeed. We arrived safely at Goblin Valley and we did a quick location scout to find the area we wanted to capture.
So we are scouting for an ideal spot. We just want to have something that has a beautiful, you know, a great single still frame composition for our video. Of course, we're going to move the camera, but, you know, we want to get something with good depth, good layers, that we can have our 3D photoscanned goblin be in the middle of. So we're just trying to find a good one that we like, and there's so many to choose from.
These ones over here are kind of little. Do you like those?
I actually do like the little ones,
yeah. Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah? Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
Okay, so these ones are, this one's I think is pretty ideal because we should be able to get to the top of it. And if we have enough time, we can hop over and get that one as well.
Now that takes us to step number 3, finding proper lighting. Okay, the general rule of thumb here is you need even lighting when doing the photo scan. And what that means is no harsh shadows. So if you're outdoors, that means you want to film during a cloudy sky rather than a clear sky so that you don't have those harsh shadows from the sun. Right now, the light from the sun is pretty hard. So it's coming direct without clouds in the way. And so you see these shadows under my eyes. So a lot of shadow and all that detail will go into your scan if you do it in the middle of sunlight. So you want to do your scan during an overcast or cloudy sky. Or the other option is to wait maybe to that window just after sunset called magic hour. Not to be confused with golden hour.
So this is golden hour. Harsh shadows, but beautiful golden light. As you can see right now, major shadows. So all of that shadow detail, if we did the scan right now, would be baked in. Or if I moved and we caught my shadow, that would throw off the information. So it's important that none of that information is there. So we gotta wait another 20 minutes before the sun goes down, and then we'll get our beautiful shots.
This is magic hour. Soft light, we look beautiful. There's a golden glow on the horizon. But this is the ideal time that if you don't have overcast to film or record for the photogrammetry using the app. Roll B-roll. All right, step number 4, start your capture. You want to orbit around your object slowly from a wide distance.
Perfect. So I'm starting wide, and then we just do some circles and get closer and tighter.
Then move in closely and get the best detail you can.
Get up in there, get that goblin.
Good general rule for photogrammetry that I've been using for years is to always look at each surface and try to see it from at least 2 different angles.
And I'm also going up underneath. You want to get at least 2 angles on every surface, right? So a lot of these overhangs, if you only shot them from above, you'd miss their geometry.
And the app just figures out that you're filming the same, they just put the image together.
It's just triangulating every little spot, trying to figure it out.
So with complex objects, you're going to need to kind of approach it from top, below, all over the place to make sure that you get good coverage of your scan area.
Oh yeah, this one's gonna be a good scan. We're getting nice, even light as I orbit and orbit and orbit. It's very boring. It's kind of like scanning a document by hand in 3D space.
I mean, that's super exciting though, if you think about it.
You really think about it, yeah, it's very exciting. You look like someone who has no idea how to film something properly. It's like, why are they just filming the ground? Shouldn't they get the background? Why are they just taking pictures close up of the rock?
That leads to step number 5, uploading, processing, and then editing your scans. So as long as you have Wi-Fi, you can upload your scan and then it will kind of process it. And after it's done computing, it will spit it back and give you the raw scan data that you can then go in to publish. So we're actually gonna go in here. I published a couple already, but I'm gonna go ahead and grab Goblin number 1 and I'm gonna show you some of the cool features we have in here. So if I click edit, you can see that we've captured a whole bunch of space in the app. So I don't need most of this capture, so what I'm actually gonna do is click the crop button. But there's really only 2 rock features that I captured in this particular area, so I wanna make sure that those get in there, and then all that other information wasn't terribly important. There's also some cool features in there where you can add objects to your scene and mess around with it. They have a whole library of fun objects, so let's just say you wanted to decorate your room. If you're a visual artist, a 3D artist, you can do some really cool effects even just within the app to create a final product that you can share with your friends. So, but let's talk about what are some of the actual practical applications of doing photogrammetry. Well, number 1, we are making an epic film this summer called Alien Country. And we're going to be filming in all sorts of locations around our home state of Utah. Remote locations that now with this process, we can take our team and friends to virtually. But you could use this application for visual effects. For example, my dog Rebel just loved Goblin Valley, but we couldn't take it home with us. Instead, we took scans, and I used the download feature from the app, took that scan, cleaned it up, I brought that into After Effects, tracked the footage, and boom! Now she can digitally play in Goblin Valley from the comfort of our own home. So if you want to learn a little bit more about how to do those visual effects or how I cleaned up my scan, make sure to sign up for our free visual effects course where I break that down step by step. We also break down techniques of how to track 3D objects in your footage, like, I don't know, let's say you wanted to track an X-Wing in your nephew's backyard. We cover all of that, so yeah, check out those videos, click the link below, and make sure to download the Display app using Indie Film School's link, and if it's free, so like, why not? You know, it'll be the coolest thing you do today, so you might as well do it, and then you can tell your friends about it, and they'll be like, wow, you're really cool that you know about this cool thing, and it's all about being cool. Thanks for watching. We'll see you later on Indie Film School.